What's up, everybody? It's Rebel Link for coopkings.com, and this is So You Want to Record Video Games, the guide. So just as the title alludes to, this is going to be a guide and walkthrough, tutorial, whatever you want to call it, that covers how to record video games. Whether you're into montages, walkthroughs, or just want to record yourself in general, this is going to be a good brief overview on how to do that. All the way from, if you have a really low budget, you can't spend a lot of money, I'm going to show you the equipment to get and how you can start recording right away. Or if you have a high-end budget and you want to do some HD videos, then I'm going to show you that as well. And the other thing we're going to be talking about is once you've done recording your video and you happen to use some of the devices I mentioned, you know, what should you render out with some of the most popular editors out there. So I've actually searched YouTube and found some really good links to each device that I'm going to go over, and I'm going to point out probably some of the best settings I've seen, and they will give a walkthrough on how to set up those rendering settings. So as we go along, I'll be sure to point that out and show you guys a website to go to, or the YouTube link to go to. So with that said, let's go ahead and get into it. First and foremost, you're going to need a computer. Doesn't have to be this specific computer, this is just some random picture I found off the internet. But you will need a computer, because when it's all said and done, when you're done capturing your footage, you're going to need to upload it somewhere, render it somewhere, and then upload it somewhere. So preferably desktop is the way to go, mainly because if you decide to upgrade your capture device and you need more RAM or you need a better video card, a desktop will enable you to do that. Not to say that any laptops are not well compatible for capture devices. In fact, they're probably better suited, mainly because of the mobility. But you know, preferably, if you can get a desktop, you're just going to be better off. That way, you can keep up with the evolution of the capture device. Now, I'm not going to go into specifics, but you do need at least an average computer. And when I say average, you know, some sort of decent video card. If you have the stock one, no worries, you can always upgrade. Some sort of decent RAM. If you have the stock, again, you can upgrade. And the processor, which if you have decent RAM and a decent video card, you know, you can overcome the fact that you don't have a great processor. But anyways, I'm not going to go into specifics, because by the time I even go into specifics, it's going to be outdated anyways. So whatever Best Buy is offering as its slowest entry-level computer in the Sunday's magazine, if you get that with the most simplest capture devices, you're going to be okay. Also, if you're able to, keep everything in one area. So I'll give you a snapshot of my workspace here. So as you can see, I've got my computer, speakers, console, capture device, monitor, etc. And everything's immediately available in one area. And you know, you have immediate access to it. So as opposed to, you know, let's say if you have a computer in another room and it's a family computer, and you have a long cord running to it, and then somebody trips over it, or somebody goes on and looks at what you're recording, says, "What the hell is this?" and stops it, whatever the case may be. This allows you to keep everything you're working on in one area and know it's working, because again, just as I mentioned before, there's some capture devices that do not indicate to you that you're recording. So if it's in another room and it's not recording, you don't know it, you're going to be pretty mad when you go back to find out that it's been either shut off or unplugged. So again, if you're able to, once you have your computer, have it near you. Alright, so you have a super low budget and you want to start recording games. This, my friend, is as easy and as cheap as it gets. If you notice in the top left corner, that's a screenshot of a program called Windows Movie Maker. and it's made by Microsoft, and you can find it for free at Microsoft.com. It's a very simple video editor, so once you're done recording your videos, basically you open them in this file, or this program, excuse me, and you edit with it, and then render out. So, I mean, that is as easy as a video editor you get. You won't get to do all the neat, flashy things that you may see in other walkthroughs and montages, but that's a great program to start off with if you've never used any video editing programs at all. Also, if you notice in my description, I put a link on one of the better tutorials I found on how to use Windows Movie Maker, how to set it up, the settings, and basically a walkthrough from point A to point B. Very good stuff. So here's some of the equipment. On the top right corner, you're going to see what's called a splitter, also known as a Y splitter, also known as a Y cable, whatever the case might be. They're really easy to find, especially if you just type some of those searches in Amazon.com or Google. Bottom right corner, that's the first capture device that I'm going to go over. It's called EasyCap. It's probably the cheapest capture device that you'll find in the market for standard definition recording. And as of today, which is in August 2009, I found it on Amazon.com for $14.11. So it's pretty cheap. And of course, you're also going to need an extra pair of RCA cables, also known as composite cables. And that's, you know, the last picture towards the bottom. So you can probably kindly imagine already from just viewing this picture that you plug the splitter into your EasyCap, and then your Xbox or PS3, whatever you're playing with, will go into one of those holes, and then your RCA cable will go into the other one and go into the TV. I'm not going to go into specific details on how to set up, because also in my description, if you notice, there's a video, there's a link to a video about how to set up and record an EasyCap, using your EasyCap device. Not only does it go over how to set it up from scratch, but it also goes over what specific settings he uses to record his video and what he actually uses to render out. And at the end of the video, he actually gives you an example of the quality setting that it puts out in a recorded video of him playing Halo. So, really good device, and again, for everything that you see here, you probably pick this all up for $20.32 is what I calculated. So basically, $20, and you're up and running.